Well, on behalf of the many researchers who are involved in this project, I'd like to welcome you to the Urban Age and tell you a little about what the project is about. Ricky Burdett and I started the project. We thought that we needed to have an interdisciplinary approach to understanding the problems of modern cities, and in particular, that we needed to have focus on the relationship between the social sciences and concrete planning, that is, between the visual and the social, between architects, planners, engineers, one side, economists, sociologists, anthropologists, on the other. And that is the DNA, if you like, of the urban age. It looks at the relationship between social and visual with a practical view of mind, which is to make better cities, to serve physical needs and also the human needs of the people who live in them. That is a project, it's a simple project in a way, and a very complicated project. I want to say that this project could never have been done without the amazing team assembled by Richard Burdett. He doesn't like being embarrassed, so I won't say anything more about this amazing team, except that he is amazing. This is a very English trait, which is embarrassing, which I would like to thank, in particular here, Wolfgang Novak and his team for building and arranging this setting in which we are, which mimics the same setting that we have in Berlin. We're grateful to them for doing that. When the Urban Age started, it was a time of turbo growth. Cities like Mumbai, Shanghai were growing at rates that actually had very little precedent in the history of urban development. And the discussions we had as a group focused on, in part, how to harness this, enormous growth, and also, of course, how to be part of it. In the last year, the urban age focus has had to change because the global economy has rapidly transformed the fortunes of cities. A gift that America has made to contemporary civilization is the subprime mortgage. And we are today living in cities with the consequence of this gift, which means that growth will be much slower, that access to resources will be much more difficult. For the urban age, this will mean a change in two ways. One of them is that in the future, we have to focus more on questions of labor and employment than we have in the past. Most of the cities that we visited, with the exception perhaps of Berlin, have been cities that couldn't find enough workers to match their growth. Today, and in the future, we will see a different situation. And secondly, and this brings me to the subject of this conference, that the resources available for development are going to focus us on smaller projects, more intimate projects, projects at a local rather than metropolitan scale, simply because that's all the money we have. Now, in my view, this is an opportunity rather than a limit. It means that focusing on the smaller scale means we can also be more inclusive of local populations than much of urban development has been in the last decade. We put an enormous emphasis in the design of this conference on the question of intervention, which really shapes the subject of the second day. And I hope we'll all have a chance to discuss and to ask questions about how we retool the growth of cities for an era in which resources are diminished, looking at this not as academy, but also as an opportunity. So I hope you enjoy today's events. It's an amazing collection of people, especially myself. And we look forward to learning from you, a city that seems at the crossroads of questions of strength and growth. So thank you very much for having us to São Paulo, and we look forward to a long and productive relationship.